Keeping up with today's fast-paced world can be difficult. Accelerate your life with iFiber Communications high-speed internet. Surf, stream, and game like never before. Give us a call at 509-754-2600 and find out more at iFiber.tv.
Officials with the U.S. Forest Service are expecting a potentially active summer for more than just wildfire this year. After months of data collection on the Okanagan-Wenatchee National Forest, entomologists are now issuing warnings about the possibility for a sizable outbreak of the Douglas fir tussock moth.
We went out and started looking at some of these areas, and we found heavy populations on both sides of Blewett Pass, around Fish Lake, where there's a lot of recreation, and also in the Methow Valley near the Early Winters Campground.
The nondescript grayish-brown insect is known as one of the most damaging defoliators found in the forest lands of the western U.S. and has a history of causing severe impacts on the health of several different tree species if left unchecked.
These insects will grow larger and larger all summer. They'll get to be about an inch and a half long, and they really can strip the needles off of Douglas fir from top to bottom. Douglas firs, grand firs, and sometimes spruces. And they really can kill a lot of trees.
Although periodic outbreaks of the pest are a natural part of the ecosystem, the U.S. Forest Service will utilize a biocontrol agent to safeguard the public in high-use recreational areas.
They have very irritating hairs, so when people are around them, this really becomes a public safety issue.
The natural insecticide, known as TM Biocontrol 1, is an organically occurring virus which is harmful only to the tussock moth. Its application will be administered aerially in a mixture that also contains water and molasses.
It causes the outbreak to collapse prematurely. And once that happens, we're not likely to see another one for another 10 years.
The Forest Service plans to treat upwards of 8,000 acres of public land with the sticky solution in Chelan, Kittitas, and Okanagan counties beginning as early as mid-June, with long-term management strategies such as thinning and prescribed fire to follow later this year. The last severe outbreak of the tussock moth in Washington occurred from 1999 to 2002, when over 45,000 acres were defoliated by the infestation. Reporting for iFiber One News, I'm Chris Hansen.